Hello mentors, this is Saurav. In this video, we will learn how we can publish our HTML or static website to the Firebase. It means whenever you deploy or publish your website, HTML or static website to the server, so anyone can access your website from anywhere. Okay, and it's totally free of cost. So that's the third part. In the first part and second part, we have learned how we can create HTML website, and that's our website demo till now. Okay, now let's publish this website to the server. Okay, let's start. So let's open the VS Code. Okay, and I'm going to open here. Click on here, you can see open folder, click on it. And we have created one website in our download folder. Okay, and you can see in our download folder we have our my website folder, this one. Click on it and click on open. Okay, fine. Now click on this view option and you can see the terminal. Click on it. Now we have terminal. Okay, now before publish your website, you need to download the Firebase CLI. But for that, you need a NPM. It means Node.js. So first of all, we are going to install Node.js. So open Chrome or any browser and just search your Node.js. Simple, nothing. And go to the Node.js download. And you'll find your Windows, Mac OS. Okay, so if you have Windows, you just need to go to the Windows and install it. So I have Mac, so I'm going to install this Mac. And just need to click on this and you can see the download is starting. Now you just need to double click on it and just click on next, next, next and install this Node. It's simple, it's not tough. Okay, after this, I already have installed it. So what I will do, I'm going to check that's the version of Node. So what I will do, npm space dash and v, and you can see 6.4.1. let me just make it bigger like this, I think. Yes, okay, cool, right? Npm version. Now we have installed successfully. Now what we can do here, we will create one simple project in the Firebase. Okay, so let's again go to the Chrome, open new tab and just type here Firebase, simple, and open Firebase, firebase.google.com, and you have to log in into Firebase, then go to the console option. So right now that's my project here. Now click on add project here. You can see add project, click on it. Now let me just type my project name. So TCB website, first TCB website, something like that, and click on continue. And you can disable this, you don't need to worry about that, and just click on create project and wait some seconds. Now click on continue and wait some seconds, and you can see basically three options: iOS, Android and web. So you need to click on this web option, click on it. Now click on, you can see the checked, also set up Firebase hosting, yes, checked it. Now just define your name. So I'm going to define my first website something like TCB website something. Okay, now click on register app, just click on it. Okay, don't need to worry, if you have any doubt you can ask me on comment. Okay, and now you need to just click on next. You don't need to do anything here. Okay, just simple click on next. And now here you can see that's the command. Okay, npm command. Now we already have installed npm, right? So now just copy this. Okay, click on and go to the your VS Code here and paste your command here, simple, and just click on enter and wait some seconds. It takes some time to download this Firebase tool. Okay, I am facing some error. Okay, so what I will do, as it is paste this error, what I will do, I will add sudo sudo in the front space and then enter. Okay, and I have to put my password, laptop password, and wait some second. Now you can see this one is successfully installed. Okay, now if you are facing you can try with without sudo. If you are facing the error, so you just need to add sudo option. Okay, now go to here and we have already done it. Now click on next. Simple. Now here you can see the Firebase login. Now just copy this. Okay, now just paste it here again and then enter. And this will ask you that, wait some seconds, you can see allow Firebase to collect CLI uses and error reporting information. So I will say yes, why, and then enter. And this will redirect to the Chrome or some browser. Now we have created our project in this email ID, okay, in my TheCodingBus email ID. Now I will select this account, okay, and wait some second. And you can see the allow, let me just allow this. Yes, and go to the here. You can see success logged in as the codingbus at the gmail.com, right? Now go to again our Firebase here. We have done completed this process. Now we have to do what? Init, Firebase init. So just copy this again, go to the here terminal and paste it and then just enter. Okay, and now you can see there is an option. We have to configure a hosting. So you have to use arrow key to move. Okay, I am using down arrow key and up arrow key. So you can see the hosting option, hosting, configure and deploy a Firebase hosting site. So you have to go here. Now you have to click space to select this. Make sure this is important. Click on space. Now this one is selected. Now we need to click on enter. Okay, now you can see use an existing project and create new project. So we will use existing project because we already have created our project, okay, in the Firebase, right? Now click on enter and this will fetch my lot of projects. But what we have created, we all know that our TCB, you can see first TCB website that we have created, okay, before some time, like 2-3 minutes ago. So that we have to just arrow, use arrow like that and just enter. Now you can see what do you want to use as a your public directory. Okay, this will allow as a public what will happen here. Google automatically fetch your all files from your public folder. If you don't have public folder, so you should create this folder. Okay, now he can see we have created folder document. He can see the download. He can see my website, this one, and he can see there is no public folder. Now I'm going to create new folder and that folder name is public. Okay, public. Now I will move my files, three files here in the public, and I will change my file name website.html to index.html. Simple. Okay, my website name is index.html and I have moved all these files to my public folder, not this Firebase debug log. Okay, now go here and you can see this will redirect. So I will just write here public and you can just enter, no matter, public. Now this will say configure as a single page app. No, just select N and enter. Now this will say set up automatic builds and deploy with GitHub. No, N and enter. Now public index.html already exists, override. No, don't override it, enter. Now we need to select, what we can do, go to the here, we have completed init. Now we have to deploy, select this, now go to here and just paste it and then just enter. Okay, and wait some seconds to deploy our website. Right, now you can see the URL, right, https fire first tcb website dot web dot app. Now let's click on the follow link and you can copy this link or control and click on follow link option. Follow link, this one, open this link and let's see. Here you can see that's our website, right? It means now let me share this website with in the incognitive, open with this website. And here you can see this one website is secure also. So we are getting the SSL certificate free of cost. And that's our website. It means I can share this website with anyone. And this is the hosting from Google. So you don't need to worry about anything, right? So that is the process of how we can create basic HTML, how we can learn basic HTML and how we can host our own website to the server. Okay, so that is the overall setup and series for that. Okay, we have created almost 3 videos. In the first and second videos, we have learned how we can create HTML website step by step, and in the third part we have learned how we can deploy or how we can host or how we can publish our website to the server using Firebase. Right, so if you have some doubt and if you are facing some error, so just comment on the video. I will try my best to solve your problem. Okay, so thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel, like this video and share this video. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye-bye.